Hi, this is Justin from OSI Affiliate Software, and in today's video, we're going to be looking at how to improve your SEO on your Shopify website, as well as how to add Google Analytics. So first, what we're going to be doing is improving how you show up in these searches. So let's do a quick Google search to show what I'm talking about. So if I do a Google search for chew toys for dogs, this first one right here is actually a pretty good example. So here, I've got a result. So we got a title right here, best dog toys, nearly indestructible, durable dog chew. But then there's this right here, because part of the title did not fit. So whenever we're creating our titles, one thing we need to be aware of is that our entire title is going to fit, so we don't have this right here. Then they have a description, and the description does fit, as you can see. It says find the best dog toys, blah blah blah, and basically it does have keywords like dog toys, dog chews, and then dog toys again, indestructible, durable, the kinds of things that people will be searching for. So this is our meta title, and this is our meta description. So that's one of the things that we're going to be looking at when we're editing our products. So now we're going to add a product and focus on what is going in our description. So I'm going to go to products. And I'm going to click on add a product, and I'm actually going to be basing it off of this product right here. This is the Nike Free 3.0, and this is a men's running shoe. So for the title, I'm going to type in. Now, for right now, we're not going to focus on the description or really any of these fields right here. We're going to skip straight down just for this video to search engines. So here on the page title, as you can see, we have 70 characters to use. So let's use up most of those 70 characters. Now I'm going to add men's running shoes. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in my store name so that people will see what store this belongs to. So I'm going to put a bar and then the name of my store. As you can see, I'm using 53 out of the 70. So I could add an extra word or two, but I like it how it is. Okay, so for the description, what we're going to do is we're going to write something that describes the product but also has some good keywords in it. Okay, so you'll notice in my description I put things like running shoes or men's running shoes and Nike, comfortable, durable, and then the name of the product as well. So it's important to keep these kind of things in your description so that it helps you in the search rankings. And of course, once I have finished all this, I can hit the save button. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to add Google Analytics to our website. That way we can see how many visitors we're getting, what these visitors are doing, etc. So I'm going to go to analytics.google.com. Now you will need a Google account, so I'm going to click access Google Analytics. Now I'm going to go over here to admin, and over here under account, I'm going to click create new account. Now if I scroll down, we're going to give it a name. We're going to call it Shopify. Now I'm going to give it my website name, which is standard sneakers. Now I'm going to give it my URL for industry category. I'll do beauty and fitness, and set my time zone to central time. I'm going to keep all these boxes checked. However, you can change this however you want. And I'm going to click on get tracking ID. Now, once you've read through all of the agreements, you can click I accept, and here you go. You'll get your tracking code. So what we're going to do is we're going to select it and copy it. I just hit Command C. Now we're going to go back to our Shopify dashboard, and we're going to go to settings. We're going to scroll down here to Google Analytics code, and we're simply going to paste that in and click Save. And once you click Save, you are done. If you need to go check your analytics, all you have to do is log into Google Analytics, and you can find some information about who's looking at your website, how long they're staying, and things like that. Once again, this has been Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos about e-commerce marketing. If you want to learn more about marketing your Shopify store, please click the link below.